Who are you?
Lois. Lois Lane.
I think that Lois very much was ahead of her time. You know, because the 50s, post-World War II, we went back to that perfect homemaker kind of thing, and she wasn't that. And I think it was really important to have that as a role model for girls my age.
Lois has always been there. I mean, she was Superman's girlfriend. She actually had a comic book that was called Lois Lane, Superman's girlfriend.
My agent said, well, you're going to play Lois Lane. I said, Lois Lane, Lois Lane, Lois Lane. So I dashed out to buy a comic book, see what she looked like.
I'd take my allowance, and that's when comic books were a dime, and I would go to the drugstore and buy Superman comics. I was a Superman addict.
I had watched all of the movies, of course, and was in love with the idea of it.
I had no knowledge of Lois Lane at all.
Lois, do you suppose you could get an interview with Wayne?
You bet I can.
Noel Neal and Phyllis Coates, who played it in The Adventures of Superman, played it very rough and tumble gal, who could keep up with Clark.
Don't tell me you think you're a human lie detector.
Not exactly.
Cut it out. Only Superman could do a thing like that.
Lois Lane, bless her heart, was pretty much a working girl like I was going to be, you know, in the business.
I watched Noel Neal when it was first on.
Just remember, somebody tried to dynamite you earlier today.
This is the very middle of a big city, it's bright daylight, and I'm a big girl.
She was spunky, she was Lois. She just was a career woman, and she didn't take any crap from anybody.
Don't bother, I think it's dead.
The problem with Men of Steel, there's never one around when you want one.
And then you get to the Superman movies, where Margot Kidder played her as sort of a combination of both. The woman who was in the comics, who was romantically infatuated, but at the same time had a lot of that Phyllis Coates and O'Neill part of the character, where she was just a tough broad.
My goodness, don't you ever let up?
Before. I mean, I've seen how the other half lives. My sister, for instance. Three kids, two cats, and one mortgage.
Yeah.
I would go bananas in a week.
Oh, can I take you to the airport?
Not unless you can fly.
Well, she was very funny in the script and had just a fabulous smart-ass quality, which I kind of related to.
You really shouldn't smoke, you know, Miss Lane.
Don't tell me. Lung cancer, right?
I think you very much play Lois in accord with your cultural times. And we were in the 70s. The women's movement as a mass movement really just caught fire in the States in the late 60s. Suddenly, you could be smart and you were encouraged to be and outspoken and go after whatever career. And it was that quick a change. So for those of us who went through that and really did feel quite literally liberated, it was huge. And you took that value that you had learned. And I think even unconsciously, to a certain extent, you put it in your characters as an actress. And seeing as Lois's big thing was her job, I think it went with the turf. I mean, I think it was all there before. I just don't think anyone had attached the word feminist to it before.
You are low man. I am top banana, and that's the way I like it.
Teri's Lois was great because of all the reasons Lois is great in The Adventures of Superman. She is not a wimpy, I just want to get married to this greatest man on earth type character, which in the comics she had been a lot.
But winning and losing is not the sole object,
well,
Lois.
This is perfect. I win, you lose, we're both happy.
On Lois and Clark, they play Clark as a very competent reporter. I actually believed that Lois could fall for a guy like that. This was the place where you got to see what could happen between two reporters working hard, spending a lot of time together, and actually just ultimately respecting each other so much that they fall in love. She just was in character as Lois, very appealing.
I'd love to play Den Mother, Chief, but I got that LexCorp story in a half an hour.
The writers and animators on the cartoons take all the human stuff that has worked on Adventures of Superman and Lois and Clark and Smallville and play it against the fantasy stuff that live-action shows have a limitation about making it work. They gave us the fantastic, but kept the heart of all the characters.
I modeled it after Rosalind Russell and His Girl Friday. It's very fast-paced, no-nonsense, she's got a sharp tongue.
I'm gonna personally lead the army that vaporizes you too.